Oh, it ain't so easy, is it? You almost lost your place. And perhaps you're wondering how you're going to cope with your disgrace. Well, your wealth is well established and your friends were never few. And all the things they told you of you're finding to be true. Well, if truth can free the guilty while the innocent must die, then I respect, respect, respect the coldest lie. And you talk of human justice while you drive on fancy wheels, and you push them to their limit just to see how nice it feels. Well, it doesn't really matter if she's living or she's dead. You just drive away, forgetting that your bumper's dipped in red. But if that's the kind of justice that our Hall of Justice claims, then I respect, respect, respect old Jesse James. And most cordially they caught you and they asked you to obey. And they threw you into prison just in case you could not. Well, King Arthur jousted Lancelot, who stole away his wife, and your lawyers jousted with the court to save your precious life. Well, if living is what matters, though you lie with every breath, then I respect, respect the ones we put to death. And you won your case most easily, and soon you will be free. Oh, but there will be a million more who lose their liberty. Not because of what they did, but what they did not do. They did not pay a lawyer or a judge to see them through. Why, they had no friends to call on and they could not raise their bail. Well, if the winning is what matters, I respect the ones who fail. Time to discuss or debate what is right, what is wrong for our people. Time has run out for all those who wait with bent limbs and minds that are feeble. And the rain falls and blows through their window, and the snow falls and blows through their door, and the seasons revolve mid their sounds of starvation. When the tides rise, they cover the floor. And they come from the north, and they come from the south, and they come from the hills and the valleys. And they're migrants and farmers and miners and humans, our census neglected to tally. And the rain falls and blows through their window, and the snow falls and it blows through their door, and the seasons revolve mid their sounds of starvation. When the tides rise, they cover the floor. And they're African, Mexican, Caucasian, Indian, hungry and hopeless Americans, the orphans of wealth and of adequate health, disowned by this nation they live in. And with weather-worn hands on bread lines they stand, yet but one more degradation. Yes, and they're treated like tramps while we sell them food stamps, this thriving and prosperous nation. And window and the snow falls and blows through their door, and the seasons revolve mid their sounds of starvation. When the tides rise, they cover the floor, and with roaches and rickets and rats in the thickets, infested, diseased, and decaying, with rags and no shoes and skin sores that ooze by the poisonous pools they are playing. In shacks of two rooms that are rotting wood tombs, with corpses breathing inside them. Oh yes, and we pity their plight as they call in the night, and we do all that we can do to hide them. And rain falls, blows through their window, and the snow falls in white drifts that fold, and the tides rise with floods in the nursery, and a child is crying. He's hungry and cold, his life has been sold, his young face looks old. It's the face of America dying. First floor, on the first floor, on the first floor, there's a young girl reeling, her body's numb and without feeling, as illusions dance on the midnight ceiling. Now she's falling, now she's kneeling. It's almost like she's bowed in prayer, a savior she's about to bear. She screams for help, but no one's there. On the first floor, on the first floor, people walk the halls, but none can hear her desperate calls. There is no sound beyond the walls, so to the telephone she crawls. She telephones her only friend, the one on whom she can depend. But the phone rings on without an end, then rings no more. On the first floor. On the second floor, and through the picture window you can see them all. They're laughing and they're dancing, admiring the Renoir that's hanging on the wall. But in the master bedroom, where the coats are piled high, a silent satin lady thinks of what it's like to die. And as she dwells on all the years she still has left to face, she wonders how she'll ever find someone to take his place. Then suddenly she's jarred by the ringing of the phone. Oh, why do you ring now, just when I want to be alone? So she walks into the bathroom and drinks some water from a cup. But the telephone stops ringing, just before she picks it up. Very poor, so I worked hard to be secure. I married one I had to wed, and not the one I loved instead. When I was young, my blood ran wild, but we stayed married for the child. Now three flights up, I'm all alone. My wife is dead, my child is grown. My daughter leads a wayward life. She's been a failure as a wife. And though she lives just one floor down, she never calls or comes around. Step off the platform and onto the train. Look out your window and into the rain, and watch all the buildings that pass as you ride, and count all the stories that go on inside, and then ask yourself if it must be this way. Should walls and doors and plaster ceilings separate us from each other's feelings? Guess they understand how lonely life has been, but life began again the day you took my hand. And yes, I know how lonely life can be. The shadows follow me, and the night won't set me free. But I don't let the evening get me down. Now that you're thank you. Your thoughts are just for me. You set my spirit free. I'm happy that you do. The book of life is brief, and once a page is read, all but love is dead. That is my belief. And yes, I know how loveless life can be. The shadows follow me, and the night won't set me free. But I don't let the evening bring me down. Now that you're around me, and I love you so. The people ask me how I've lived till now. I tell them I don't know.